Welcome to the New England Aquarium. I am Emily. I'm a penguin aquarist here, and I am standing in our penguin colony exhibit here to tell you how our exhibit is built for our penguins. So my job is to give the best quality care to our penguin colony here. And part of best quality care is actually the exhibit that they live in. Our exhibit is based off of standards that are given to us by the AZA, or the American Association of Zoos and Aquariums. A good exhibit will give positive reinforcing enrichment that stimulates behaviors that can be found in the counterparts in their natural habitat. Penguin exhibits are multifaceted. They have water, they have to have land. Our air and our lighting are all extremely important when creating a habitat. Now, penguins are usually associated with water. They spend almost 75% of their lifetime in water. It's a huge deal. And as you can tell, our exhibit has a ton of water. It actually has 150,000 gallons of filtered Boston Harbor seawater that comes in. And 1,800 of that gets filtered every minute, so it's constantly being cleaned. They also use the water to help them preen. It helps them get hard to reach spots and areas that they might not be able to get to on land. So the water is extremely important for our birds, and we have to make sure it's great. So we have an awesome environmental quality team that helps us test the water every day to make sure the pH balances are great. We monitor the water temperature to make sure that it's in that 50 to 60 degree range that they usually swim in the wild. When they're not in the water, our penguins are also on land. That's where they go through some of their important life cycles, such as breeding, nesting, and molting. African penguins live in South Africa and Namibia off the coast, and they'll usually live in large rookeries off of rocky islands or sandy, shrubby areas. So our islands are there to represent it. They offer different levels and little nooks that they can kind of hide in order to give them different options. We also have sprinklers on our islands. This helps clean off our islands and offers a different type of enrichment for our birds. With 6 islands here in our exhibit, you find that birds tend to gravitate towards one or another. So Jaleel here considers island 1 part of his island. He's always on it, his territory's on it. You'll find that you may find many of the same birds on the same island every time you come. So air is extremely important for birds too, just like us. And good quality air is a great sign of quality care. So we have to have our air completely circled out all the time. We also have to do air testing. Our great environmental quality department also will test our air just like our water to tell us whether or not our air is doing great. One thing you might not know is our lighting is super important. Our lights are actually programmed to follow the sunrise sunsets of the Northern Hemisphere. So every day they change just a little tiny bit to follow that course. So then on the longer days of the year, our penguins go through their molt. They start to lose all their feathers, they regrow new ones. And then on the shorter days of the year, which we're getting to, is breeding season. So that's when they start building nests and they lay chicks. And so our light cycle is super important to their life cycle. And our lights also fade in and out, just like a sunrise and sunset, to give it that ambience and to really show the birds that, hey, it's time to do this life cycle. A good exhibit that is enriching for penguins can not only give our penguins the best quality care, but can actually help the penguins in their natural habitat. So African penguins, which you have been witnessing here today, are in danger. A lot of it is from habitat destruction. And by being able to observe our penguins and how they act in our exhibit can aid research in how to help the African penguins in their natural habitat. Thank you everyone for joining me. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below or come visit. And if you have, and ask a penguin aquarist. We're in the exhibit 2 to 3 hours every morning and afternoon, and we'll be happy to answer any questions. We hope to see you soon.